There it is.
Rock lung.
What a lovely name.
It's extremely accurate.
That's going to be my first child's name.
Oh my god.
Stop it. You can't get some Jesus Christ. Name my death metal band that.
I mean, she could be named after the death metal band.
Fuck's sake, that was like on point and everything.
How come my sister's name is Roses? Well, son, that's because your mother and I like metal. Thanks, Dad. No problem, guns.
So, I'm assuming someone explains this to us?
Yeah.
Well, Oriana, you know the general autopsy report for yourself.
Yeah, bitch ass, start explaining.
I am trying! You guys can...
Everyone in RP, come on!
So what is it?
To put it in its simplest terms, it starts out... Mostly you just have a terrible cough that hurts like all hell, because your lungs are basically on fire. And it slowly gets worse and worse, until you're literally deteriorating. And it can be mercifully quick, but most of the time, unfortunately, because the twins has a very hardy constitution, they last a bit longer. And I suppose in my case, hardy constitution saved my life. It doesn't really have a cure, it just keeps going.
Well, hold on now. In your case?
It was kind of the reason I ended up in Duvros in the first place.
Zol, like, moves his chair, like, three spaces down.
She flips over her mask and pulls out the thing. The purpose of health. There we go. It's like, they gave me this, it's fine. Also, it's not contagious from me. Well, until the last stage. But I'm not dying, so...
I'm sorry, what?!
But you still have it.
It's magically non-existent.
Well, it is definitely still there, though.
Well, if it's of any assuagement to you, Ms. Oriana, I've heard tell many a tale where defeating the creature and wrenching its guts from it might offer a solution. A literal solution, a cure. I don't know if that's the case of this, but I imagine if anyone could figure it out, it would be either the Seekers themselves, or I can commune with my mentor. See if he knows anything.
Say her. Do I feel like she's holding stuff back from us?
Roll insight.
Can I also so roll smart. Insight on that same thought process?
Yeah.
12 insight, nice.
That's suspicious.
I think he's probably going to do better than me on that one. Nah. Yes.
Just said anything.
Is she holding information back to a degree? She never discloses who her mentor is. But in terms of, like, the validity of the information she has said, that is true, and you as a bard can attest to that, too. There's many a legend and fairy tale about that exact scenario happening, right? It's like, how do we save the princess? Well, you kill the white dragon, rip out its eye, make it cry a tear, and give the tear to the princess. Laughs in Sekiro.
Right, so... The death and utilization of pieces of its corpse is pretty common in these sort of things.
Yeah. It's usually, like, sometimes there are creatures that have a natural capacity to undo the thing they do, either to protect themselves or for some further process in their ecological existence. Others, it's a matter of... I brought you into this world, I can take you out, but in, like, a, you know, magical way.
Then I have a couple of questions. If you had that currently, Oriana, would you be able to be infected?
I don't think so, but also with this item, I can't be affected by pretty much any disease anyway, so it's an irrelevant factor for me. Oh, wait. I think I got the thought process. Do you want to give it to someone else if it's not going to affect me?
If we might be able to procure at least one of those for our front line, we could prevent its spread, should it be a problem.
I think procuring more would be extremely difficult. But... I don't think it'd be impossible. Could look into it.
You said it's a breath attack that affects your lungs, correct?
Mm-hmm.
This thing just exudes this gas.
Oh.
Just being near the fucking thing can infect you.
Oh, that's fun.
Oh no, it has way worse stuff. Don't worry. We'll get there when we get there.
So it just kind of radiates the gas.
It can like yeet the gas at a target. It can't do that. It can congeal it like sort of like a spore pod from StarCraft and like chuck it at people.
This man is just a walking mustard gas bomb.
Yes. Mm. Man, it's as if it's a weaponized disease that has no cure.
That's fucking wild. It's almost like it's a bio.
We were talking about this. It's like, there is no cure. By the official wording of this, there is no way to cure yourself from the disease. It just gets worse. It only gets worse, because guess what? When you make a weaponized disease, you don't really care what happens afterwards. Why should there be a cure? Curious is the trap maker's art.
Yeah, and if it's on our side and our side gets affected by it, that means they were dumbasses and gassed themselves. So they deserve it.
Hmm. Well?
So actually, I think after you explain this to him, he would just be like, Abigail, the Seekers and Slayers employ rebreathers for underwater operations.
There are very little, if any, underwater operations. Not exactly many large bodies of water to partake those in. But if you mean if there's some sort of rebreathers that they utilize for gas-based attacks, yes. I know Duvros itself had use of such apparatus. Although in that case, it was less of a rebreather, more of a arcane mantle.
That's interesting.
Do you think it would be possible to procure?
You'd have to bring that up with the captains. Don't get me wrong. I'm sure the captains will mean well for their troops, but they are not their troops.
She has a point. If it would go to anyone, it would probably go to their own folks.
And Seekers and Slayers are the, arsenal is rather divine or personally tailored. If that's the case, then it won't work on people that don't have care of that same conviction. Seekers, on the other hand, theirs are much more general use, but they guard the gadgetry very, very deeply. So, you'd have to bring it up with the captains.
We can do so during the meeting.
If you want to get a head start on it, you could talk to Seeker Captain Janik. I know he's the one stationed here in town. Or you can talk with Captain Rickard. He's the one that came into town with me.
Rickard. Is he Seeker or
Understood.
Slayer? There's a Seeker and a Slayer. Seeker, Captain Rickard.
Don't worry, I'll type it out for you.
Yay!
Seeker, Captain Rickard? And then there'll be Slayer. I mean, you guys already met Slayer Captain. Good idea.
Immediately spelled that one.
And then the Slayer Captain stationed to Duvros currently would be. Captain Roderick.
Understood. Then we have names. He just looks over at Alessander. Do you think your outfit might be able to provide some if they do not?
Would I know if they could? Probably not.
On such short notice? Background information at disadvantage.
Yeah.
Do you have history?
Yes, I do.
Your choice of history
or take background. A bardic die.
So at disadvantage though, right?
Yeah. But you can't take the bardic die though.
So background.
Bardic.
You will have an 18 plus 3.
I know! Plus 3 and exactly that. Do you want to use a bardic?
Yeah. If he's given it to me.
It's a d8.
Cool.
Nice. Fun. So was that 21, 27?
Mm-hmm.
Big numbers.
Would they be willing to offer you guys them? There have been many instances where Seekers and Slayers outsource services to mercenaries or adventurers or back in the day, knight the orders. These days, obviously, a lot less. Would they be willing? Absolutely, there is a chance. But it is a case of, like, you have to prove that you aren't just going to die of their equipment.
Mm-hmm.
Or else then you're just a waste of time and investments. Because, less so for the Slayers. Slayers is like, oh no, we lost a plate armor set and a sword. Alright, we got, like, a bunch of those back at base. But the Seekers are very protective of recovering their equipment. or ensuring that it's destroyed before they leave the field.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't need to power up the shit that's in the twins with your own tech.
Exactly.
But hold on, was that Redain's question?
If they're willing to provide... was that Redain's question?
If the Silver Sworn could, if they couldn't. But that's good information, too.
Yeah.
The Silver Sworn. With matches the history roll. The Silver Sworn have worked with the Secret Slayers in the past, although that was a while ago, back in the extermination periods in the South.
Makes sense.
But there is a rapport there. You might want to... you'd have to find either a very tradition or history appreciative Seeker or Slayer.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe there's a really fucking old Seeker or Slayer, but you doubt there's going to be one around for that conversation.
Yeah, they'd probably be in the spires, if anything, down here.
Bingo. So, with all that in mind, Alessandra will say, I can guarantee you that any rebreathers that the Silver Sworn have are quite unused. Out of date, I suppose. Expired, even. I suppose I could try to lean on past relations to see if they would lend us some rebreathers for the sake of this mission, but they would not want to give us their equipment if they don't think we are a worthy investment.
Then we'll reassure them that we are.
Indeed. Personally, I think you are all worthy. I have not seen you fight, but you do strike me as people that know how to handle themselves for one reason or another. But then again, I am not a seeker, nor am I a slayer by any means. They will be harder to convince.
Well, if it's a showcase that you're attempting to do, Abigail looks at Oriana. Now would be the time for it. I invite all of you to attend. I personally am curious to see your capabilities myself. And the less variables that they don't know about, all the better.
I don't think that they would appreciate my typical skill set.
No, they would. Make no mistake, I'm well aware that Seekers and Slayers have their own biases and prejudices against otherworldly talents. But at the end of the day, they will suffer the lesser evil, work with the lesser evil to defeat the greater evil. There are a number of cases for that, my own hometown included.
Which, as amazing as you are, Sajar, I don't think you're going to outshine a hag by yourself. Yet.
If it's truly a fair judgment that you're seeking, I can try to go rouse Slayer Captain Garadia. He's... among a number of Seeker captains who are charged with training. That being said, make no mistake, they're capable trainers. They are equally capable warriors.
So we'd have free reins to use any...
If anything, Captain Garada might try to put some last-minute lessons into you.
Well, I'm always with
it.
Too many voices.
No, there's none.
Now there's none.
What if you say something?
Stopped.
I finished what I was saying.
No, it is a good idea to maybe get the other practice in. For that.
If nothing else, you should at least see how the Seekers and Slayers will potentially operate in the field.
Definitely. I also had a question. Sorry, I was going to ask earlier, but then we started talking about more important stuff. The place we're going, what was it described as again? Sorry? It was...
A small island in the middle of a marsh, a delta.
And you said there is entrance to this, yes? We're not going... You know, we're not...
There are land bridges across the delta that emerge when there's a less wet season. But when it rains or pours, it gets covered up by the water.
What's the likelihood?
Hmm?
What's the likelihood of it being flooded?
A dry season.
Well, it hasn't rained too much as of recent. There have been some foggy mornings, as she gestures around, like today, but it seems Mod United favors us. For the time being.
Okay, good. That's fine. That is that was.
Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine. I'm fine. Not a fan of swimming. That's all. But
Amber rolls insight.
Can I also roll insight on that?
Insight. You guys can all roll insight by giving Amber advantage because girlfriend.
This makes sense. This tracks.
All right. Thank God for the advantage.
And insight.
Oh my God.
Fucking throwing a dice on there because
20s, baby.
I'm using all my goddamn dice right now.
But you're on 111 sheet.
Yeah, I'm very stupid. Hold on. I was wondering why.
I was like, there's no way your insight's that piss poor.
No, considering I have it proficient, so.
I don't know, Kirsty. What do they detect?
Well.
All of them had. Look at these numbers.
Yeah, everyone got fucking 20.
Yeah, I guess so. She's looking a bit panicked at the thought of what she's sort of saying, I guess. There's definitely like a bit of a, yeah, like her eyes are a bit like, fuck, kind of thing.
We can mark down that she is not a fan of water, or at least large bodies of it.
Mm-hmm. That makes two of us.
So like, can you swim at all? Yeah.
Amber like sort of stirs out of her sullen state and puts a hand on yours. Hey, it's all right. Mm-hmm. We don't need to deal with the water. We probably just, I don't know, have you on the shore and just shooting at people.
I can deal with that. I can deal with that. I mean, my hair just goes everywhere and it gets wet, you know? So, yeah.
Amber gives you like a smile. Yeah, I get that.
Mm-hmm.
It would be an excellent way to neutralize the gas.
Liliana does raise a good point. Can you actually swim?
Me?
If the push comes to shove, can you swim? Another lesson to teach her, huh, Liliana? How to read and write and how to swim.
She just pulls out like a small notebook and is just like taking notes. Just like,
if I might chime in on that, don't try to teach at the same time. Why the hell would you try to teach? No, never mind.
I don't want to ruin the books or the paper.
I mean, that's not really exactly the. Never mind. Toys just go back to the book.
One must be prepared for any situation.
Did you drown a kid trying to teach? No, never mind. I want to. Eric just pats Tullus on the top of their head. It's okay. Some things sometimes are best left unknown.
But even she has a smirk on her face.
There's other than that, though.
So. Where do we start? I believe some want to go to post office, yes?
Yep.
Yes. Correct.
And others of us go to Slayer compound, yes?
I want to take care of one small thing. I have to stop by the orphanage again. But it...
So I just shrugs.
It'll be quick.
Like,
that'll be fine.
You go by yourself. It's on as far away and you're not wanted target.
Well, there are people looking for me.
Yes, I can come and spy on you for a change.
All right. I'd appreciate the backup, honestly.
Oriana's going to the Slayer compound after. Right?
After.
Yeah, she's going to go there and then go.
Type and roll 20, child, where you're going. too many things. Core NPCs are going to the Slayer compound. Vagrants. Voss will go to the Slayer compound. America and Tulsa will go to the Slayer compound, but they probably won't participate in any fighting. Zol is going to the post office. Abigail, of course, will be accompanying you guys to the Slayer compound. Although she might try to go find Slayer Captain Garadia when she gets there, so you guys will be away from her for a bit.
I'm lying to Jesus Christ.
Yep, I will go with her, but not with the intent to fight, the intent to convince whoever needs to be convinced.
Fair enough.
This is a terrible time for my H key to be broken.
Yay!
Oh no!
Your H key.
Just do what the French do. Ignore it.
Rich key.
I would, but it's in Sajar's name.
So, I mean, you can still do Sajar without the H. It's just not as...
I could. I just copied and pasted, though.
You're just putting... Fair enough. That's smart. <honestly. laughs>
You guys set on out, then. Let's go to the cradle first.
Alright.
Cradle crew first. Cradle crew! Mm-hmm. Woo! So that is Alessander, Oriana, and Anushka. Anyone else? Nope. Mm-hmm. You guys head on over to the cradle. Mm-hmm. You guys are unassailed. Oh, well, rather, Anushka, you are questioned about your presence in the city once, but you do flash the papers, and you're fine for the time being.
You got the paperwork for that devil.
Oh my god.
You got a license for that permit.
You son of a bitch.
Well.
You got a permit for that license for the permit. That's right.
And we pick her up from jail.
Jail? She wouldn't make it to jail.
You can pick up from the tree. Anyway, so you go to the cradle. And it's in basically the same state. There's not like a change really that much in like the one night you guys are away from it. There is a retinue of some slayers here. Slayers and seekers here, rather. At the medical... Well, I guess he would be relocated to the mentally destitute ward. I re-listened to the cradle one-shots and realized that they didn't just go by orphanage and stuff like that. No, they had even more depraved names. Like, the mentally destitute ward.
Your brain just said no.
Yeah, it was a mentally destitute ward, the medical... the hospital, or I think it was physically crippled ward, the criminally insane ward, and the orphaned ward.
That one. The orphaned ward's the easiest one, but also it's sad in its own regards. The fatherless wing.
So you guys go over to the mentally destitute ward. There's some seekers and slayers there. They're just sort of like meandering. There's only like three apiece that you guys see in the main lobby. And as you guys walk in, the Slayers do get a bit tense as Anushka walks in, but the Seekers seem to have been given the heads up about you, so they're chill, relatively. I'm sorry to tell you Slayer Mallory is here.
No! The mean lady's here.
Well, well, well. Look what the cat dragged in. And what the fuck do you guys all want here, huh?
Actually, the cat's not here right now.
She looks at you. No one laughs.
Stare her back.
Anushka just hiding slightly behind, like, Alessandra at the back or something.
Fear not, we're not here to conduct any untoward rituals or anything of the sort.
I don't know, that bad joke was pretty terrible in its own right.
That it was, that it was. We shall repent for it later.
That's pretty like bad.
Lightly,
I recommend I recommend flagellation. So what do you want?
Look at Oriana.
Well, I want to go talk to... I wrote the name down. I want to go talk to Appentino, which isn't really related to what you guys are doing, so I'm gonna head that way.
Yeah, you guys are... I shouldn't say you guys are in the Mentally Destitute Award. I had to go buy the Mentally Destitute Award.
Right.
And they're just sort of perched out front.
Yeah. Just parked out front. Why are there, like, six of them here? I don't want to talk to them.
There's only six that you see.
They come here to bully the...